So as you can see, we have a safe point, so let's get on. No, I think I just want to see what's over here. I think those are crows and not, you know, the type of zombie crows. 10 out of 10 ambushes.
This must be their den.
Exactly what I expected, hunting the lichens. Now, from what I... Of course, it spawns behind me, why not? Thank you for the cheap tricks. Hey, finally remember to do this. Equip the part. 19 bullets, right? Well, I hope that did some damage to them if they fall off the vine. Okay, let's just wait over here. Oh man, I missed that one. Okay, he might have been the last one. That's probably not the sound I wanted to hear. What do I need for bullets? Gunpowder and scrap. Did I kill him before he hit me or no? Okay, the music is dying down, but I don't want to jump down there. That would be suicide almost. Why do I have a feeling this is infinite enemies? Probably it is infinite enemies.
Okay, big guy.
I'm sorry, didn't I block that? This game is getting on my nerves. I know it's supposed to be tension, drama and all of that, but still. Is this the end? Okay, let's explore this arena a little bit more. Wow, that was not so bad. But at the same time, it was very bad. Should probably just rush that place and kill everyone over there, but still. I had a feeling you are supposed to, I don't know, do this slowly, but yeah, this is one of the things you have to rush. Yeah, I guess there's nothing over here except your sudden death. Yeah, whatever you do, don't jump down here. It's a death trap. Can I just refuse to fight them? Apparently there are infinite spawns and one of the things I hate in video games is just infinitely spawning enemies where they push you forward. Of course you don't know they're infinite until you test it, so yeah. Oh nice, even more magnum ammo. I guess if you just enter this place, you stop the spawning. Maybe have spoken too soon. Okay, little goat, you'll be my friend. And I hear a very, very big guy down there. I guess this is where we have to equip the magnum. Also, I have one more pipe bomb. 3 heals. Yeah, I have a feeling we'll need these. Oh, this is actually a well. Let me guess, it's the Warias or Warias. Come on, move, move, move. Oh, I'm supposed to look over here. Let's see. Well, there's a pile of bodies, there's a lot of lichens feedings. Looks like their den is getting really thin at this point. So that's why the bodies are hung up like that. Because they are supposed to be kind of like off the ground, so the worms don't get them or something. Yeah, look at those, they look so happy. It's almost like an entire ecosystem. They're feeding on the corpses that are just hanging over there because reasons. Well, I guess they're semi-intelligent, which is exactly what they wanted to show. So this is the real den of the lichens. Until this point, we're just fighting the guards, I presume. So, yeah, while those guys were dying and defending their lair, these guys were just eating. Sniper, explosive rounds. Okay, let's take a quick tally. I want people to see this because, hey, you might need this. So, 7 magnum bullets, 23 sniper rifle ammo, 10 grenades, well, that's actually a lot of grenades. Okay, now let's save. I'm pretty sure there was supposed to be a treasure somewhere around here, but I don't care at this point. A lot of pixel bugs, look at that, that's a bug. So funny because, I don't know, the game is just too scripted in my opinion. Oh, all of those hungry lichens over there, and when you go over here, it stops. Well, okay, let's go in full immersion. We are eaten, we are smart, we are heading into lichen werewolf outpost. Yeah, let's jump down into the obvious ambush number 5. I'm not sure if we can actually... That was the magnum. Wait, wait. I'm losing my focus over here. I'm losing my focus just because this is silly. I miss point blank. Yeah, I've really lost my focus. Oh, and again with the lichens. So let's equip this. My favorite things. Okay, that was a very bad fight, sorry about that, but hey, it's not all about winning. Exactly. It's not all about winning, having the perfect composition, having the perfect strategy. I actually lost a lot of stuff over there. But to be honest, that's why I was saving everything for these fights. These fights. Yeah, some of the fights in this game are very weird, just because you don't know what to expect. Some of the fights, some of the areas in the game I've been doing totally blind, and some of them I've been doing while looking at some guides. Oh, nice. I mean, not complete guides, just reading. Here, you have to do this and go there, so yeah. But I had a lot of things to spare, so I guess that makes it okay. I mean, otherwise, why would you spend so much time gathering stuff you don't really need them? Okay, we have gotten everything from here. Let's just leave this place. That was annoying, to say the least. Okay, we need to get all of the shinies. Probably the last one is somewhere in this crystal pile. Okay, let's be cool about this. Cool and collected. Let's keep searching. I mean, I don't want to give up, especially now after I've beaten such a fight. I mean, it's technically not so bad, but as you saw, just need a lot of items and ammunition in. And yeah, if you keep your flash, I mean your explosive rounds, you'll have no problems. Also, I had a few mines left again. My first time doing that boss fight on hardcore, so I didn't want to risk it with the mines or other stuff. Okay, let's see what else. Where else could it be? Oh, very weird. This one looks like loot, but when you get closer to it, it changes. Okay, I was probably looking at it, I didn't notice it. Okay, we got everything completed. Goodbye, crystal. By the way, this doesn't really explain why you have so much crystal after the enemies die. I guess it's kind of like natural formation. Maybe it's kind of like how the mold communicates or stores its information. Or maybe after someone dies, the mold collects its information via the crystals and they are put in random places, I don't know. Hey, explosive rounds, my favorite, give me more, please. I guess you have to take the torso flask. Why is Ethan having visions? This is also a very bad point.
You're the real deal, Ethan. Well done.
Quit hiding, asshole. I'm not letting you get out of this.
Cool your jets. Just a little bit more, and you're all wrapped up. I'll lend you a hand. So in exchange...
In exchange what?
First of all, come to me. Put all the flasks in the altar, and I'm sure you'll figure the rest out. See you, Ethan.
Well, see you, Heisenberg.
God damn it.
Carl. Okay, nothing to look over here. Just a little bit longer. I mean, that was pretty interesting, yeah. Guglielmo's plate. I guess this was the treasure. Huh. Also, this is weird again. Let's not look at the picture. The more you look at it, the weird it gets. Okay, let's get into the boat. I kind of smell... I want to say I smell one of those jump scares, but I guess nothing bad can happen to you while you are in the boat. And this is just meant as a quick way of transportation and nothing else. Yeah, can you believe they actually programmed and designed this whole level just so you can ride a little boat for 50 meters? Yes, and we should be exiting in the graveyard. Nothing over here. The graveyard near the church. Follow plot, what? Okay, this is not free loot. We'll have to spend something to get out of here, I'm sure of it. Oh, this is like a little infirmary. Phantom fish. Well, we already caught the fish, the pig, and the... What was the other thing? The fish, the pig, and the... The bird, yeah. I think trouble focusing because this is kind of scary a bit. Subjects 174, 181, so 7 subjects. Mihai M, which is Romanian name. Silversmith, scars from pneumonia. Low affinity, cadeau failed to grow. Body transformation, dropping cognition, another lichen sent to the pasture. Well, I guess they're all injected with a wolf spine liquid or whatever. Bernadette B. Female, no occupation, no history of illness. Result, death. Female, noble descent, no, not from the village, hereditary blood disease, very high affinity, no loss of cognition. Alcina D. So she was 44 years old, not from the village, and hereditary blood disease. That's why she had to drink blood and eat human meat, but again, not from the village, noble descendant. I'll be able to control body transformation, apply cognition control procedure, send for observation, nice. Hey, I guess this is where Lady Dimitrescu was created. And under the graveyard, what? That makes her a little more spooky. Now I've learned my lesson, they need a shotgun shell. One shotgun shell and 3 or 4 bullets. 1, 2, 3. Too bad they don't give us a sword. That's a beautiful sword, by the way. It looks like something it would be used by a knight. And this is the game. It gives you ammunition, it takes ammunition, it gives you lights. It's all a number game. Okay, so we got everything from this place. Let's just get out of here. Yeah, that was basically the token force that was kept here to defend it. Okay, so this is the last part of combat that we do in the village, and next will be the factory, which is one of the most interesting places in the game. Unlock it. Why would this door have an unlock button on the inside? Well, I guess it makes sense since it was the entrance to the laboratory, otherwise they don't make them like that, right? For the dead to come back? No. Okay, at this point I'm a little, I don't know, disappointed. I mean, got everything everywhere, killed them for dead. I mean, he's not dead, but as you can see, that was his domain that we just destroyed, or semi his domain. Okay, let's go for a quick save over here. To be honest, I'm happy I got so much ammunition and saved my ammunition and the show must go on. And got all of those other things because now I could actually, you know, enjoy the game a little bit on hardcore. Yeah, it's so good to waste ammo. Still not happy with my ammunition situation, but I have a few pipe bombs, mines and grenades and healing items, which is okay. Hello, my friend the Duke. How are you?
It's my greatest pleasure to see you return alive. You wish to make a purchase?
I think we all need someone like that. My greatest pleasure to see you return alive, yeah. Five of them, one large crystal, one Vivianite, yellow quartz, crystal skull, nine of them. Perfect crystal skull was... okay, that was from the armor lichen. Wow, only 35,000 for the crystal hammer. Well, that's actually pretty... Most of the giant's crystal eggs because we killed the whatever cannibal stuff it was named. So yeah, they should give you more money for the Uriah's hammer. I mean, look at this Uriah's hammer. It's almost the same as the crystal giant. And also 22,000, that's not a lot either. That plate is basically for free.
Splendid! Do you know its worth?
I know, because you tell me. Well, okay, so for the benefit of the game, I'll just sell everything I have, including the meat. Yes, I don't think we'll be using it anymore. Poultry, fish, meat.
Little and often fills the purse, as they say. Food is life.
Exactly.
I look forward to seeing the fruits of your exploration.
Now we have cleared up the inventory a little bit. Let's save the game here as well because I was worried something bad would happen to me over there. Now let's do all of this and in the next episode we'll go to the factory. I mean, you don't have to insert them, which is kind of nice. So now that we have inserted all of these things, what do you do with the chalice? By the way, that's the umbrella sign. Okay, let's go to the ceremony site. See you next time, Duke. It's kind of funny that the umbrella logo is, you know, in here.
What's going on?
Yeah, is it Chris punching boulders again? Or okay, I think Chris this time is punching mountains. Oh, and look, the factory is right over there. Let's actually investigate this a little bit. So, Umbrella logo. Oh, it's even bigger on the outside over there. So you just move the giant shells from one place to the other. What good does that do? No, I want to get off this crazy train. This is not what I signed up for. Well, at least I'm rich. I mean, if you go and die in a crypt, at least you can be happy you're rich. Now this is actually going down for a very long, long time. So, okay, are the Umbrella the original founders and keepers founders? Yeah. In the sense that they founded and also found.
Don't worry about the kid, Ethan. It'll be fine.
The mold.
Just get your ass across the bridge.
Okay, so this bridge opened up, and as you can see, the factory will be huge. It will be a big level with a lot of enemies to shoot, and oh, it will be marvelous. Also, it will feel like a Wolfenstein level or a Doom level. Maybe I should use some of those flashbangs. Probably for the first time in the game when I have 4 healing items. I can probably make more, I can make more healing items, one more. Okay, let's just save here and then I'll end the video. It was quite an interesting getting over here. See you next time, bye!